James Halliday saw the future, and then he built it. He gave us a place to go, a place called the Oasis.
This is a scene from the movie Ready Player One. In this scene, the protagonist, Wade Watts, enters the Oasis, which is a virtual world in which he can interact with other humans in the form of avatars. They are looking for an Easter egg that gives them full power and control of this virtual world. So yeah, it's a science fiction movie. But in the upcoming few years, some elements of that movie won't be fictional anymore.
CEO Mark Zuckerberg introduced what he calls the Metaverse, a platform where users will interact in virtual and augmented realities. He also said Facebook would change its name.
All right, let's talk about the Metaverse. The Metaverse is a fully immersive online world that looks similar to ours, but is computer generated. So basically, it's a virtual reality in which we can interact with other humans and objects using our avatars. Many technologists think that the internet will eventually evolve into the Metaverse. Now, immersive virtual worlds is not something new. It's been there for a while in the form of video games. You have games like GTA, Call of Duty, Fortnite, Destiny, and many more that allows you to interact with your friends using your game character. But in 2019, something new and different happened.
Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go!
American DJ Marshmello held a virtual concert on Fortnite, a concert that Fortnite gamers were able to attend with their friends. It was a huge success, and 10.7 million people attended that concert in the game. It was the first time, for me at least, where a virtual world was used for something besides gaming. It was used for something more social. And now Mr. Mark Zuckerberg is taking this to the next level.
To reflect who we are and what we hope to build, I am proud to announce that starting today, our company is now Meta.
Facebook, or Meta, is planning to build its own metaverse, a digital world comprising virtual reality headsets and augmented reality. Mark Zuckerberg's vision includes avatars teleporting from one place to another, working together in a virtual office, buying and selling digital goods, good news if you're into NFTs, and even combining the offline world with the online one using holograms. And to be honest with you guys, I'm scared. Don't get me wrong, I'm all about innovation and will probably test the metaverse when it's out, but I'm scared because I'm afraid I'm gonna be hooked into this virtual world. Because I know Facebook will do everything in its powers to make sure that happens. They've been doing it for the past 17 years. One of the things Facebook is good at is retaining active users. They have to. We're the product, so they have to retain us. According to Quetra's data, of the 52 million Facebook users it tracked, 98% are still using the app 90 days after they installed it. So yeah, they have 17 years worth of data from over 1 billion users on what works and doesn't regarding retention. I'm afraid that when I enter the metaverse for the first time, I'll be tricked and influenced to like it immediately. Come on, we've seen this in so many movies. People will eventually like the virtual world more than the real one, and yeah, nobody will leave their homes. Now you might say, you don't need to test it out. Maybe it won't take off if people decide not to use it. This is definitely possible, but there's a very high chance that someone from our circle will be testing it, and then the fear of missing out or FOMO will kick in. 56% of social media users experience FOMO. And guess what? Facebook is the platform that provokes the most FOMO compared to other platforms. Also, remember how FOMO helped the Clubhouse app get traction? People were begging and searching for ways to get invites to join the platform. That's why I believe when the metaverse is launched, it will take off. Now, if we circle back to the movie Ready Player One, Nolan Sorrento is the antagonist in this movie and he wants to be the only person controlling the Oasis. Mark Zuckerberg might become the real-life version of Nolan. John Carmack, who is the consulting chief technology officer of Facebook's VR division, warned against the metaverse being under the control of one company. He says, "The problem is that if you make a bad decision at the central level, nobody can fix it. You can cut off entire swath of possibility, things that might be super important. I just don't believe one company ends up making all the right decision for this. And it makes sense, because there are so many existing virtual reality platforms out there, so it'd be nice to see all of these companies collaborate in order to bring the metaverse to life, instead of being controlled by one company only. It's gonna be very interesting to see how this thing unfolds and what kind of regulations will be set during its development. It's gonna take a few years to develop the technology required to launch the metaverse, but with Facebook or Meta investing more than $10 billion on the project and hiring more than 10,000 professionals to develop it, it's not a matter of if the metaverse will be launched, but when. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna create a part 2 of this video when we have more information, but until then, let me know in the comments section what you think about the metaverse. And yeah, make sure to like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.